Welcome to the lecture on fluid mechanics. In this video lecture, we are going to briefly discuss about viscosity and types of fluid. The content of the lecture is viscosity or dynamic viscosity, kinematic viscosity, effect of temperature on viscosity, and classification of fluid. Viscosity, the property by virtue of which a fluid offers resistance to deformation under the action of shear force is called as viscosity. Example, I have taken three different fluids over here. First one is water, second one is cooking oil, and your last is honey. Your water is a less viscous fluid which flows easily from one beaker to another beaker. Cooking oil is a viscous fluid. The viscosity of cooking oil is more than water. Therefore, the flow of your cooking oil from one beaker to another beaker is low compared with water. When you take honey, it is a high viscous fluid compared to these two fluids. Therefore, it takes large time to flow from one beaker to another beaker. Another day-to-day life example for viscosity is when you are rubbing your two hands, heat will be generated. Now, between your two hands, if you have water, it offers resistance and the heat generated will be low. Whereas, when you use oil in between your two hands, the force required to move the two hands will be less because the oil is a high viscous fluid compared with water. We are going to briefly discuss about viscosity. Consider two plates where one is fixed and another one is movable. Here, the bottom plate is fixed and your top plate is movable. The two plates are separated by a thin layer of fluid. Over here in this diagram, we have few number of thin layer of fluid separating the two plates. F is the force required to move the plate and A is the surface contact area between the fluid and plate. Considering behavior of two layer of moving fluid one over another. Now I am going to take only these two layer into our consideration. In this graph, the x-axis denotes the velocity and your y-axis denotes your distance. The velocity of the bottom layer is u and the velocity of the top layer is u plus du. The distance between these two layers is dy. The upper layer moves with higher velocity relative to the lower one. The relative velocity between these two layers is du. Considering the two layers of the fluid, the upper layer which is moving relative faster causes a shear stress on the lower layer in the direction of flow. The lower layer causes a shear stress in opposite direction of flow. The tangential stress tau between the two layers is proportional to velocity gradient. Velocity gradient is also known as rate of shear strain. Velocity gradient is the ratio between the change in velocity to change in distance. Tau is directly proportional to du by dy. To remove the proportionality, mu has been introduced, where mu is the dynamic viscosity. Du by dy is velocity gradient. Next, we are going to discuss about SI unit of viscosity. We know that mu is equal to tau divided by du by dy, where tau is shear stress and du by dy is velocity gradient or rate of shear strain. we know that the shear stress is load by area and velocity gradient is change in velocity divided by change in distance. The unit of load is Newton and the unit of area is meter square. The unit of change in velocity is meter per second and for change in distance is meter. Further cancellation, we get the SI unit of viscosity as Newton second per meter square. The CGS unit of viscosity is poise. 1 poise is equal to 1 by 10th of Newton second per meter square. 1 Newton second per meter square is equal to 10 poise. 1 centipoise is equal to 1 by 100 of poise. Kinematic viscosity. The ratio between the dynamic viscosity and density of fluid is known as kinematic viscosity, where gamma is equal to mu divided by rho, where mu dynamic viscosity, rho density of fluid. The SI unit of kinematic viscosity, where gamma is equal to mu by rho. Mu dynamic viscosity in Newton second per meter square and rho in kg per meter cube. Newton can be written as kg meter per second square. Therefore, on further simplification, where mu is equal to in kg per meter second. So, on further simplification, the SI unit of kinematic viscosity is meter square per second. The CGS unit of kinematic viscosity is stoke. 1 stoke is equal to 1 centimeter square per second, where 1 stoke is equal to 10 to the power minus 4 meter square per second. 1 centistoke is equal to 1 by 100 of stoke. The effect of temperature on viscosity. The viscosity of liquid decreases with increase in temperature. The temperature has a greater impact on viscosity of liquid. Now considering an example, I am going to conduct a pourability test on an engine oil. On a cold condition, the oil flow is less, whereas when the engine temperature is being increased, the oil flow is more. It indicates that when the temperature is being increased, the viscosity of the fluid is decreased. The viscosity of gas increases with increase in temperature. Temperature is directly proportional to viscosity if the fluid is gas. Considering an example, a bottle fitted with balloon. When it is being heated, air starts to expand easily and the size of the balloon is being increased. It indicates that when there is a temperature rise, the viscosity of the gas also increases. The viscous force of the fluid majorly depends upon the cohesive force and molecular momentum transfer. The cohesive force is more important than molecular momentum if the fluid is liquid. The cohesive force decreases with increase in temperature with the result of decrease in velocity. Considering an example over here, when the temperature increases, the bonding between the molecules is being loosened. With the result, the cohesive force is being reduced. Therefore, the viscosity of the fluid is decreased. The molecular momentum transfer is more important than cohesive force for gas. Here, the fluid is gas. The molecular momentum transfer increases with the increase in temperature, which results in increase in viscosity. Considering example over here, when the temperature is being increased, the molecular momentum transfer increases between the molecules. which leads to increase in viscosity. Classification of fluid. The fluid is broadly classified into Newtonian fluid, non-Newtonian fluid, pseudoplastic fluid, dielent fluid, ideal plastic fluid, and ideal fluid. First, we are going to discuss about Newtonian fluid. It is a fluid in which shear stress is directly proportional to rate of shear strain or velocity gradient. Tau is equal to mu into du by dy. When we plot a profile between velocity gradient and shear stress, here your velocity gradient is on your x-axis and shear stress and y-axis, we get a linear line which indicates if there is an increase in velocity gradient, there is an increase in shear stress. Some examples for Newtonian fluid are water, kerosene, and mineral oil. Next, we are going to discuss about non-Newtonian fluid. It is a fluid in which the shear stress is not directly proportional to the rate of shear strain or velocity gradient. Tau is not equal to mu into du by dy. When we plot a profile between the velocity gradient and shear stress, we get a parabolic path which indicates that there is no linear relationship between velocity gradient and shear stress. Some examples for non-Newtonian fluid which we are using in our day-to-day life are gel, toothpaste, ketchup. Pseudoplastic fluid. It is a fluid in which the apparent viscosity decreases with increasing deformation rate. Here, n is always less than 1. Tau is equal to mu into du by dy to the power of n. Now, we are going to plot a profile between velocity gradient and shear stress. We get a curve. In that curve, from the origin point, we are going to draw a straight line. See, over here, when we take the slope between each and every line, the slope starts to keep on increasing. Some examples for pseudoplastic fluid are human blood, slurry mud, and milk. Dielent fluid. It is a fluid in which the apparent viscosity increases with increasing deformation rate. In this dielent fluid, n will be always greater than 1. Tau is equal to mu into du by dy to the power of n. When we plot a graph between velocity gradient and shear stress, we get a curve. Like your previous condition for your pseudoplastic fluid, if we draw a straight line from origin point over the curve, over here the apparent velocity keep on increasing. Some examples for dielent fluid are starch, butter, and a sugar solution. ideal plastic fluid. The fluid which possesses a definite yield stress, but then the relationship between the shear stress and angular deformation or velocity gradient is linear. Tau is equal to tau y plus mu into du by dy. When we plot a profile between velocity gradient and shear stress, initially a huge amount of shear stress is being absorbed. After that, it follows a linear profile. Example for ideal plastic fluid. First, sewage sludge, toothpaste, oil paint. Now consider a toothpaste over here. See, initially there won't be any flow of your toothpaste from the tube. But when you are giving your initial stress, after that we get a continuous flow of your fluid. This is a perfect example for ideal plastic fluid. Ideal fluid. The fluid which has zero viscosity and zero shear stress is called as ideal fluid. When we plot a graph between velocity gradient and shear stress, we get a straight line on x-axis. It indicates that when velocity gradient is being increased, there is no movement on your shear stress. It is an imaginary fluid which is not at all available on real condition. The profile of different fluids are being compared in the graph below. The graph is between velocity gradient and shear stress. Newtonian fluid, non-Newtonian fluid, pseudoplastic fluid, dielent fluid, ideal plastic fluid, ideal fluid. An ideal fluid is an imaginary fluid. Thank you.